Have you ever wondered if there is a society within the society? Even in the tiniest drop of water, there lies hundreds of thousands of living organisms functioning according to their own laws. Out of these organisms, the water bear is one of the most insightful microscopic animals to investigate. Freshwater species of Hypsibius are easily found within a piece of damp moss. Like all other water bears, Hypsibius have a bilaterally symmetrical body with four pairs of legs. They lack circulatory and respiratory organs, but have a complete digestive system and a hemocoel type of fluid-filled body cavity that functions in circulation and respiration. These water bears are classified within phylum Tardigrades, with different species occupying a variety of marine, freshwater, and terrestrial environments throughout the world. Because of the translucent color of Hypsibius, its muscle and nervous system is largely visible under the microscope. The nervous system consists of a lobe dorsal brain and ventral nerve cord with fused paired ganglia. The eye nerves connect to the eye pigment spots in the head region. Some nervous fibers also attach to muscles within different parts of the body. When this water bear stretches its rare claws, the hind muscle movement is clearly visible. This type of movement can also be observed in other water bear genus, such as Macrobiotus. The form and symmetry of the claws are the most important characteristics of Macrobiotus. Apart from that, it has got a distinctive buccal system. The two stylets are rigid and curved from the mouth tube, with stylet sheath guiding from the mouth opening. The two flexible stylet supports are fixed on both sides of the buccal tube and works like a spring against the stylet muscles. Water bears use the two stylets to pierce through algae when eating. Through the mouth tube, there is the two semicircular pharyngeal bulb muscle structure. They help pump liquid food into the stomach. And within the pharyngeal bulb, there are macroplacoids, which works like teeth for water bear. These freshwater species are mainly vegetarians, which feed on algae. freshwater species of Hypsibius and Macrobaltus normally live 1 to 2 years. They might go through several molting processes within their life, which often last 5 to 10 days. During molting, the old cuticle, including the claws and the lining of the foregut and hindgut, is shed. Sometimes the pregnant mother shed their skin with the eggs. Eggs stay inside the mother's exoskeleton until they hatch. Water bears go through latent state when environment is unfavorable, such as freezing, desiccation, low oxygen tensions, and salinity variation. They form a dry state, which is called tun. Water bears can survive harsh conditions in tun form for years until the favorable conditions revive them. The current research interest focuses on this special ability of water bears. Research has been done to reveal the molecular basis of tolerance to those enormous stresses by decoding the genome sequence of these creatures. Genetic strain Yokozuna 1 was isolated from extremely tolerant Japanese tardigrade species within recent research. Despite their overall abundance and cosmopolitan distribution, the tardigrade have been relatively neglected by invertebrate zoologists. In addition, their development and ecology are poorly understood, and proper training of taxonomists skilled in identifying tardigrade species is essential for systematic, ecological, and molecular analyses.